maybe he figures I can't eat all the Cretel in one shot, so I'm just gonna have to bury it for later.
Some scientists are there, we had a little one, some cloudy, and had a big lab, and give me a little bone, walk out and we throw it, and you can tell you have turned on. And lab, for a while, and you're like,
go find it.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Thank you. It's nap time.
That's not bad.
I didn't see.
Oh, okay. I'm like, I keep hearing it, and then it stops, and then I hear it again.
Oh, you gotta keep it.
Good.
Oh, I saw, right after you motioned towards that, I'm like, oh, there it is. Well, I would maybe just see if he's interested at all, because he might not even.
It is nap time for everybody.
Maybe he's just on a strike and press.
You need to grab for your own.
Yeah, really?
Good.
Well, he inhaled the stuff we gave, because he wasn't on, he wasn't eating good food. Because they had already had him on a restricted diet, which I didn't know when we brought him up Thursday, nobody bothered to eat. You'd think that when they took him out of the kennel and they saw the signs all over it, that they might have stopped, passed that along with him, let alone send food with him.
Yeah.
This happened because I ran into the central pet guy that takes him out in the mornings. He's like, by the way, you know he's on a restricted diet, right? Yeah. Yeah. Well, he's been on the metronidazole for a few days now, I think like 5 days. So it should be just about,
solid, usually one out of four or five.
And then you gotta figure out which one is.
Right, and here, that is.
Well, as they say, that's me, it's like the people.
Hello, yours is mellow. He or she is happy.
He's very happy.
Yeah.
And I think it's because of the.
Very mellow.
Good.
Feels quiet.
Yeah.
It's.
This guy's figuring it out.
And that's what I would have to call.
Good.
All the time, from everything, and several, quite a few years ago, actually, that she had one of those where you swallow.
Good.
Takes pictures all the way down the road.
So getting some good snacks there.
With the doctor, and he showed what it's supposed to look like, and he showed what hers looks like, and all the little stuff that's supposed to be there, you know, like the, yeah. Yeah, whatever it is, but all the stuff that's supposed to be there, hers is just like a tunnel, like there's nothing. And he told her, he said, this is because my aunt was one of those, like, she sneezed and she called her doctor and said, I need antibiotics because I don't want to get cold. Well, problem is that you destroyed all of that, and they tried to punish it, and it just doesn't work for the body anymore.
It wipes out your, all that stuff, and everything goes through you.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like.
Well, that's, everybody says, because I'm trying to go to the doctor, I'm like, every time I take meds, I pay for it for a year afterwards. It's not worth it. I find natural alternatives to things, so that, you know, I would, it works.
My chiropractor is my primary physician most of the time.
Yeah.
Sit.
The PACC and all your blood work and all that.
Right.
Good.
You're just selling drugs.
A lot, yes, I do that. And then, but they want to get you on this one, and then you start taking it, and you start having reactions, then they want to put you on. But here, take this one to fix the problems from A. Well, now that A and B are working together, now no problems are cracked up. So we're going to give you a third pill to offset those things. By the time you're done, you're taking like 16 pills a day. And, yeah.
Everybody
if I can pop a pill. Now, I take a bunch of stuff every day, but it's all, we've talked about that before, all supplement stuff that I take. And so, interestingly enough, some of the things that I take every day, they're now, like, doctors that are trying to take a more natural approach to dealing with COVID, are now recommending it, the Corsodin, the bromelain. I take it because of my sinuses and allergies, but it's because the one is, acts like an antihistamine and the other one acts as a decongestant. And so they're now recommending that because it helps clear. It's just, it's really interesting to know how much of that stuff they're now finding. I've been thinking for years, but I get worried though. You're probably right, you know, and thanks for just crapping all over my parade.
Good.
I'll say, I can blame it all on you. It's like, it would have been fun, but she just put it out there.
Someone just took it around.
But I'll tell you what, even if it did, I would still take it because it's the only thing I get when my sinuses or allergies are both getting flamed.
Good.
I end up with vertigo.
Good.
Yeah, and the ENTs in this town are like, oh, it's all in your head. I'm like, I'm dizzy. That's what vertigo is, you moron. You know, like, yeah, and I found out from a friend of mine, she's like, try this stuff. And I tried it, and it was like, because I can't, I'm on my heart problems. So anything that messes with my heart rate, speeds up my heart, I scare all that.
Yeah.
So I don't take over-the-counter allergy meds, because that's how they affect me.
Good.
So this was like, oh, I had no side effects, I didn't get tired from it, nothing.
It's like a rocket. I used to work with it. I couldn't control myself.
Yeah, absolutely.
Good.
Hi.
So I think it was Friday. It got really quiet in bed. Because it was just like you only hear like parts of it, and it almost sounded like this rumbling kind of thing. And then I realized it was a
down.
Snoring. That's what that noise is.
Good.
It's something that's so nice you don't see. You just don't see shelter dogs.
Good. Good.
And yet it's still an artist.
Good.
Hey,
Tori. Good.
I think she's out walking. She's out with the pumper. The common bumper. That's what we'll do. We'll rename him Bumper and I'll just say the T is
silent. He big double banger.
Did you pee on everything?
Everything. Everything. You could see or not see or smell.
Good.
Oh, and you know the if you go down the back here, along the grass where all that grass grows up on the back.
Uh-huh.
So they cut it all down, but he managed to find one bush he wanted to get into, and he got all to. I was trying to get him out from the bush. I was like, that's it. He's here.
Good.
Lewis.
In the front seat? In your car?
Back seat. He needs the back seat.
Oh, I've got a thing now that I don't have. Missy, I can take whoever you brought to me. I don't have to go. But I need somebody that can sit in the front seat.
Yeah, no.
He's
that's the back
good.
Seat.
Can we wipe his eyes? Looks like a lot of it crusted off from the grass.
Well done.
Thanks.
A little dermal abrasion.
You know what we could do though? You could take Blue.
Good.
You could take him in the front seat, and we could put. I can get the crate out of my car. I can leave it here because it's Sunday. I don't need it for tomorrow morning. So I can leave that here, and then I can put my seat up and then put the thing across the back, and we can get him in the back.
These are real hard.
Lewis, we can do that. Great.
Mastiff Pit or Pure Pit?
I don't know that he's, I'm not even sure he's got PDM.
You think it's mastiff, or am I totally off
maybe,
on that?
Maybe, but I think there might be some chocolate lab or something in there because he's that color.
Yeah.
Yeah, that color.
And that color doesn't really exist in any. It doesn't. It's not in bees. It's not in mastiffs because they're a darker brown than that.
Right.
Yeah. It's they're that's why I think that's what King Koopa is. I don't think he's a pit. I think he's a mastiff because it's that darker brown.
Yeah.
I think he might have some Shar-Pei because he's got those funny wrinkles.
Shar-Pei. Okay.
But maybe not. I don't know. He's another weird. We got some dogs this week that are like.
Sure.
I'm confident he would come back as Pit and Boxer.
That
Leonidas.
Would, yeah. Leonidas, it's yours, Cass.
Yeah.
Yeah, but and I think Lewis is probably some pity, but mostly chocolate lab. Yeah. He's all pity.
He's really good.
Yeah, he's not a bad dog. Cut his conies off, and he'll stop that humping thing.
That testosterone level down.
Yeah, well, and I think that I'm hesitant because I don't want to say something to Pat, but he could be dangerous to go to somebody with children.
Yeah.
Especially
yeah.
Small kids walking around eating food, and he could end up biting somebody without any kids.
Yeah.
And they would write it off as aggression, and it's not that at all.
Yeah.
That's not what it is, 100% because of the lack of vision.
Right.
I'm actually surprised that they left him okay, given that he has that issue. But I don't think they realize yet about the food.
He's pretty quick.
What I saw with him with Don though earlier with the bag.
Yeah, he thought dinner in bed.
How's Lewis over there, John?
Yeah.
I think with him it's probably
doing wonderful.
He's chill, huh?
Yeah.
No humpies. No.
But
he's done. He loves you.
Yeah.
Love me a little less.
We do not want to curse that. Oh, isn't that cute?
No, it's not. It's not even a little cute.
You're adorable. Which
I get in trouble for too, buddy.
Such a guy thing.
Good.
Joe sat in there for a good chunk of the afternoon with him, and he just snuggled right into her. He had his head like right up against her leg, and she kind of pulled the blanket up and kind of covered his head, and he was just
Rocky.
Yeah. But the fact that this is how he's been for the last 2 days, like that's all he wants to do is sleep.
Yeah.
I truly believe.
So are we leaving the Neomac?
That's gonna
colors pop. Here.
Yeah,
they
stay here. Yeah. I'll leave the balloons on just
well, you're great still in the camera.
I know, we're gonna see what he does. I'm holding the butt. There we go.
Well,
that's
the dog, and he just laid in the
floor. You're sitting on
the
ground.
Yeah, he's got the magic.
Did you wipe his eyes?
He wiped them himself.
Oh, do not need to do it?
No, we got the rest of the crusties that kind of were out this way.
Okay.
I think the hot thing might feel good.
Yeah.
The hot towel.
Good. Good.
No, he's awake now. Are you waking up?
Good.
Did you have a nice nap?
This is boring.
It's nice and quiet. Not noisy like when I'm at the shelter.
Yeah, he's catching up on his sleep.
Exactly. A lot of them do that. that one here, actually. Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty common.
I wish you could have bought the new car.
Back to car.
I don't know if it's a great place or what. They're like mini legs. They're not even real.
Hey, they hold it up. That's all we need.
They're just all we need.
Good boy.
He's taller than him.
Right? I don't think you're like moved that fast anymore, do you? So he was just neutered on Friday too, so he's so they give them meds when they do it. It's a cocktail medication that helps when they go under, it helps when they first come out of the surgery, and then it's on board for about 2 to 3 days.
Okay.
So that's starting to wear off now.
No humps.
So I think he'll probably see a little bit.
No humps.
Well,
one up top?
Okay.
One up top?
Good.
But I just love that.
Yeah. He got back up into the front seat of my car and he's just looking at me with a big old smile like, yeah, I did that.
Good.
Licking his chops. And he was completely unapologetic about what he had done. I kept looking at him and said, you are so good.